Okay, we're gonna do the night flight again and see what we can see in L.A. I just wanted to kind of check out the basically what I want to see is the night lights of Los Angeles. Do a quick fly around. Probably nothing too serious. I'll probably go to the downtown area of LA just to kind of see what the layout of the city looks like and see what the urban sprawl looks like in the dark. See if I have enough skills to land the aircraft. It's a challenging runway. It's not impossible, but it's definitely a more seasoned pilot type of runway at night. So let's see if we can succeed in this flight here. Had a pretty long day today, so I'm just trying to relax with some flying. It's always fun for me to, even in the virtual pretend world, I've always, like I said, if I wanted to be a pilot, it's fun. Let's see what else we can come up with at the advanced age of 47. It's not that advanced, but with the coronavirus and everything going on, it's a pretty challenging time to be alive. But as long as you see the sunrise every day and keep your head about you, stay as calm as you can, you'll be alright. I think that's why I like flying, is you've got to be calm. You have no option. Even in a dangerous situation, you've got to stay as calm as you can to survive it. Being that it's just a virtual reality game, it's nothing really to fear in it in itself. Still learn from crashing and wrecking an airplane. It's not the end of the world. You do get a reset. The aircraft are unlimited in the game, so you can wreck as many of them as you want. Really, other than the city lights on the ground, this is going to be a lot of instrumentation flying.
Santa Monica Tower, Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha Meridian, runway 21 departing straight out.
Looks like we got everything adjusted, so we're gonna go ahead, and because there's trees at the end of the runway, just because I know it from a few times that I've flown, I'm gonna throttle up a little bit before I release the brakes. Give you an idea, like this is, I've flown into Los Angeles a couple times at night, and this is really what it looks like. It's just a sea of street lights and man-made lighting across the area. Pretty cool to see. I mean, it's unique. You know it's L.A. for sure, even at night. I guess with the artificial lights in the city, the light pollution, you can see the mountain ranges, and I can pick up the skyline still from downtown, even in the darkness. That was kind of interesting. Then I fly the same route that I flew yesterday. What I was looking at was actually Staples, the Staples Center for the L.A. Lakers, and then I just turned towards the west before I got to Dodger Stadium, but should be able to get a good view of the Dodger Stadium. And I was guessing right, there was some high school ball fields right outside of the downtown area of L.A. I forget the name of the high school. But yeah, it's kind of cool when you compare what's in the virtual reality and the AI of this game compared to Google Maps. I think the AI draws off a lot of what Google Maps put out there, and the imaging and the satellite imaging and everything else that goes along with it is pretty cool if you think about it. LAX over there with the blue lights. So we're flying at sea level, essentially from the Santa Monica Regional Airport or Municipal Airport. So we're about 1,930 feet off the ground. We have a good steady climb out, so we're not in any jeopardy of running into any buildings at night. Follow terrain features up. Now I was landing at sunset yesterday, and the glare off the Pacific Ocean from the sun just totally blinded me, and I was unable to see the Santa Monica Airport there. So this time around, I should be able to make my approach and pick up the airport fairly easily.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha frequency change. Santa Monica Tower Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha is 5 miles east with Sierra to land.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha Santa Monica Tower. Make left base, runway 21. Altimeter 29.92 wind 257 entry.
Make left base runway 21 Cessna Golf Sierra Alpha.
Like I was saying yesterday, I just don't see myself ever being comfortable with the idea of living in an area that's so overly populated with people. And yeah, I love movies, and Hollywood is here, and the movie industry, and everything else is here, but man, just to get around in the city's got to be a nightmare, for sure, for what they say. This gridlock traffic, and I'd have to be at night out where it's quiet at night and sleep during the day if I could. I just have never had that desire to be in Los Angeles for any length of time. LAX is pretty bad just to get through it, to go on an international flight, in my opinion. It's always exciting to see new places. But man, I prefer to go to SeaTac, or I don't know if I even really flew out to San Francisco before, but I'd rather backtrack down to Dallas Fort Worth Airport than take a little bit of a longer international flight from Dallas. Go through LAX if I can avoid it. Yeah, it's really hard to pick out the details. Look at all those traffic lights. They're all red. It's like 1,000 traffic lights. Or the car tail lights, I don't know which are those. that circular building right off of the left side of the dash is Staples Center. I can barely pick it out. Look out the left side. It's left window. Left side of the aircraft. So it's coming into view now. There's Staples Center. Circular building. Yeah, it's barely lit, but right in the center of the screen now. Oh man. No wonder I'm flying slow. I was full flaps. Or that flaps. Dodgers Stadium right here, the left side corner of the dash. That's pretty cool. I barely missed it because I was focusing on other things. That's a big facility right there. Oops. I can't hold it. That's cool. So wow, that's a big park. That's pretty cool. I bet that's a fun place to go watch a game for sure. Alright, well, enough sightseeing. I guess we're gonna head back now.
Golf Sierra Alpha, clear to land runway 21. 125, 7 at 3.
Get on the center
clear
line.
To land runway 21 Cessna Golf Sierra Alpha.
So we have the street lights are pretty easy to pick up, so it's not that sketchy as you might think. You just got to stay above those street lights and you'll be fine. I don't know of anybody, well, I'm sure there are pretty fearless students. I don't think I'd ever want to learn how to fly out of L.A. The nice thing about Colorado is you've got all these emergency landing spots, like I've said before in other videos. Gradually reducing throttle as I'm approaching. We've got four white lights on the happy lights, so we're good. We're on the right path. Our approach is really good. Not too high, not too low.
500.
We got this road here.
Going to 121.9 Cessna Golf Sierra Alpha. Santa Monica Ground Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha request taxi to parking.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha taxi to general aviation parking via taxiway Bravo 3 Bravo Bravo 4 cross runway 21 Bravo 3.
Taxiing to general aviation parking via taxiway Bravo 3 Bravo Bravo 4 cross runway 21 Bravo 3 Cessna Golf Sierra Alpha.
Okay, so we got it parked. We didn't. Yeah, that's another 30-minute video. It's pretty much shows what LA looks like in the dark and at nighttime. It's a pretty good flight. Pretty pleased with the landing. It was actually a really smooth landing on the Santa Monica Municipal or Regional Airport there. So thanks for watching. You guys have a great night. Talk to you later. Bye.